At least three people have been injured in a suspected military drone attack in Imphal West District. The attack, which took place in Senjam Shirang areas, is the second drone-related incident in the past few days. Security forces were deployed to the scene to repulse the attack. At least two explosives were dropped from the drone, in which three people, including a 23-year-old woman, were injured. The victims have been taken to the hospital and the condition of the women is said to be stable. Meanwhile, Manipur DGP Rajiv Singh has visited the attack site and has interacted with people. My colleague Nibir Deka with us on the broadcast. Nibir, take our viewers through the latest details. We are now learning of more and more drone attacks in Manipur. If you can take our viewers through the details of the fresh attack that has taken place, and also what is the news that has come in the past few days. Okay, I will be joined by Nibir, hopefully, in a very short time from now, so that he can take us through the fresh details and what really is the situation on the ground. But I'm also being joined at this point in time by Major Mohammad Ali Shah, defense expert. Major Shah, thank you so much for taking our time to speak to NewsX. I want to understand your thoughts on this fresh mode of attacks that is now being witnessed in Manipur. Suddenly news coming in of several drone attacks that are now taking place, which begs us to really ask very crucial questions as to where exactly are the terrorists and the militants now getting access to drones to carry out these attacks.
Devka, firstly, things were never brought back in control in Manipur. People were living in illusion that things are becoming normal, things are good, everything is hunky-dory, but nothing was hunky-dory. In fact, things deteriorated after third May till today. I will not call peace has come into Manipur. Now they are deadly equipment being used. Equipment, when I mean, like you just mentioned, drones, I don't know. I haven't got confirmation on that. But they are, as per what the DGP has gone and Rajiv Singh has gone and seen the site, it is really sad. And they are self-improvised artillery guns. Can you beat it? Such other stories going on in Manipur. Now, whether they are being used or not, we don't know about these heavy artillery guns, improvised artillery guns, and drones, and they're heavy. But the very fact is, it just comes to show that if we don't get things under control, they will only become bad to others. So it's about time. The nation's first priority should be to get into peace in Manipur, in a peaceful state like Manipur. The Maitis are wonderful people, the Kukis are wonderful people. Where is the problem? The problem lies where? Because so much of hatred has spread. And there was a lot of information warfare going on from both the sides. Somebody, the Maitis were calling Kukis this, the Kukis were calling Maitis that. And this is something, it pains me no end. A state which has given so much to the nation, in nation building. Ratan Dhyam, Mary Kom, Mirabai Chanu. I mean, there's so many people. The list just goes on. And if we cannot take care of our own people in Manipur, it's a very sad state of affairs. We talk about international affairs, but what about our own state, our own home? It's painful. We are talking about a drone attack. Well, we apparently earlier. So where are they getting the funds from? Where are they getting the equipment from? Where are they getting the weaponry from? It is painful. It is indeed painful to see, be it anyone. There was a video of a Manipuri policeman. He was grievously wounded. And I was deeply pained to see that. People would say, people call out names that, you know, Kuki militant, Maitai rapist. It's wrong. It is wrong to call any community or to paint any community by the same brush. So the very fact is, I say the society will not change unless and until we change our own selves. So it's a responsibility of every single individual to actually bring about peace in Manipur in whatever little way possible. It's very difficult, I know. It's very difficult, I know. Easier said than done. But that is, there's no other way out. If we don't control this now, Devika, it's only going to get worse. Right now, we are hearing about drones and about all kinds of deadly equipment. It's going to get worse then. And my danger, by the danger, my biggest fear, on 3rd May itself, on 4th May rather, on your channel, I said, you know, my fear, it should not spill out in different states. And that is That was my greatest fear. We saw what was happening in Mizoram and Assam. Slowly and gradually, they were also at risk of getting affected by this. It's contagious, I would say. The Nagas are wonderful people. The Nagas can play a very, very bridge role to bridge the gap between the two. I mean, I have just had the honor of being awarded as the Director General Assam Rifles Commendation Card a few days back by General Pradeep Nair, the former DG. So I volunteer my services to play a bridge. I am more than happy, if not anywhere else, to bring them together. They can come to, they are most welcome to my home, to my house anytime, 24 hours. And we can sit across and talk on the table. I am sure the government is doing their bit, but definitely it is not enough. Had it been enough, it would have, we would have gotten peace in Manipur. Everyone is concerned. I am deeply pained. You are deeply pained. Everyone is, every, all of you are deeply pained. What is going on in Manipur? It has to end at any cost, come what may. If we don't treat a wound in time, the wound can become even deeper and it will hurt us for the rest of our lives. I don't know how long it will take to bring in peace in Manipur. My heart actually cries for my Manipuri brethren. And yes, Devika, I really hope and pray and I commend you for doing responsible reporting from NewsX on this, Devika.
But at the same time, Major Shah, what exactly do you feel then today continue to now contribute as far as reasons are concerned as to where the government is now struggling?
Well, firstly, Devika, to the armed forces in Manipur. When I say armed forces, I mean the Assam Rifles and the army as well and the other forces who are there. The Armed Forces Special Power Act is not there to intimidate anyone. It's there to defend everyone. That was taken away from certain places. Why? Because there was a lot of pressure. Well, there should be a control. It would not be misused. So the armed forces hands are tied. The armed force, if the army wants, they can take it, they can curb the situation within no time. But the very fact is, along with responsibility comes authority. Along with authority comes responsibility. Are we giving the armed forces enough powers to do that? Are we making enough efforts? A peace committee was formed of 51 members earlier, last year, which was rejected by the peace committee members itself. They are people who are very, very passionate. Their names are not there, who are very, very, who are genuinely wishing, willing for peace to come in, and dialogue is the only way forward. I mean, how long can we have young teenage children of 17 who, remember, they went missing on a motorcycle. We had the beheading of David. We had so much of hatred from both the sides. How long can we afford that? We can't afford it for too long, Devika. We need to put an end to this, and the government should. I'm a little surprised. I'm sure the IB would be having a data of people who have served there, who know the area, the former GOC, the former chief secretary, the former governors, the former lead director general of police, the people who understand that area. I'm certain they would be having. They can form a team and they can bring people together on the table, sit down and talk about it, Nivika. And we can, a lot can happen through a discussion. A lot can happen when people sit across tables who understand that place, who are in good terms with both the communities. So we really need to put an end to this. The government can do a lot, in fact, on this, Devika.
Okay. All right, Major Shah, thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast with your perspective. Meanwhile, let's listen in to what the Manipur DGP Rajiv Singh has had to say after visiting the attack sites and interacting with the people.
Yesterday, since day before yesterday, there has been aerial drone attack so far in this area, in the Kokrug and this area. How would you look into that aspect?
This is a new thing which has happened, and we have already, Manipur police ne pehle hi tweet kiya hua hai. So it has been escalated, and we are taking it very seriously. We have spoken to everybody from here to Delhi. Or वहाँ दिल्ली में भी एनएसजी से भी हम लोगों ने बात किया है, डीजी एनएसजी से बात किया है, उनकी टीम से बात किया है, प्लस और भी एक्सपर्ट्स आ रहे हैं. हम लोगों ने कमिटी भी एक बनाई है कि ये ड्रोन के बारे में पूरा ये पढ़ने के लिए एंड समथिंग टू डू काउंटर करने के लिए उसको कैसे हम लोग आगे ये करें. आसाम राइफल एक कमेटी तो बना दी गई है, बट उसके बाद भी कुछ एक्सपर्ट्स को भी हम लोग बुला रहे हैं और जल्दी से जल्दी हम लोग कुछ इसका उपाय ढूंढेंगे। वहां पर हमारे पास कुछ है काउंटर के लिए, दैट ऑल्सो वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिप्लॉय। और प्लस जो हिल के एरियाज हैं, जो जहां जहां पर अटैक हुए हैं 3-4 जगह पे, उन सभी पे हम लोग के ऑपरेशन चल रहे हैं। कल भी हुए थे, आज भी हुए हैं, आज रिकवरीज भी हुई हैं, कल भी कुछ रिकवरीज हुई थी, तो कॉम्बिंग ऑपरेशन चलता रहेगा। तो वो बिल्कुल ही श्योर रहे कि सो एवरीवेयर कॉम्बिंग ऑपरेशन विल कैरी ऑन।
फॉर मोर सच वीडियोस सब्सक्राइब टू द न्यूज़ एक्स यूट्यूब चैनल, हिट द बेल आइकन।